This is the Halftime Show with Omar Adouri on Pulse 95.
Salam and welcome to the Halftime Show with Omar Adouri. I am your host, covering everything sport, international, local. Hope you're having a blessed day wherever you're tuned in around the world, whether it's 95 FM, Pulse95Radio.com, our app, Sharjah Broadcasting Authority, or you should be chilling us at home, watching us live on YouTube. Thank you very much. Shout out to Sama as well, who's in the building, controlling the music for me as always and making it crisp. Now, what's coming up on the show today? On today's show, we discuss the different types of body type and which one you fall under. Now, if you're wondering, what is he talking about? Let me tell you, sometimes when you take a look at someone's physique, you normally end up associating yourself with that person. So let's say if you see someone famous on TV and you say, you know what, I wish I had a body like that. But that's really not what body type I am. And with that comes a lot of things like nutrition, like training and all that. So we're going to be talking about that. And speaking about perception of how we look, we also discuss body dysmorphia. Now, if you're wondering what that is, it starts off with a condition that's more mental, but actually, regardless of how you look or how amazing you look, sometimes people might still feel like there's something missing in their body type. A roundup of the latest sports as well, and headlines, and all that's coming up this week on the only place to be at 3, the Halftime Show on Pulse 95.
This is the Halftime Show with Omar Adouri on Pulse 95.
It sure is that time. It's the Halftime Show with Omar Adouri. I'm your host, covering everything sport, international and local. Thank you very much for tuning in, whether it's on Instagram Live or even TikTok. Yes, Anaba, I see you. Hope you guys are doing great and hope you're having a great day. Okay, right. So on the show today, we're talking, it's a very conscious show today, and I think that can speak from personal experience when it comes down to this one, because a lot of the times when you actually, you know, when you work on yourself physically, mentally, there's always this thing where you're kind of stereotyped to what kind of body type you have. You know, you hear different factors in the gym, you hear different factors all around, but did you know that there are generally three body types that you'd like to kind of classify yourself under? Now, Sheldon came up with this a while ago, but what I think about this, and I kind of add to that in my book Reset, is you can transition between the two body types. So if we take a look at body types right now, and I told you that there was three different body types: ectomorph, mesomorph, and endomorph. Now, if you're thinking, wait, what? Say that again. Let me tell you. Ectomorph, the type of body type, let's see which one are you, tends to normally be quite thin, narrow, linear, and not as much muscle in your body. This is a natural type. We're talking about generally looking at someone and thinking that person looks quite slim. You know, they're quite long. That is what we call an ectomorph. Now, when we look at a mesomorph, that's the middle ground. Now, mesomorphs are normally, you know, let's say, it's hard to say this without offending anyone, because this is the thing. Again, you got to kind of own it. So for me, I'm actually between two, and they're both not that great. So the endomorph is the mid-sized, where you have a little bit of muscle, a little bit of body fat, and it's kind of condensed together, even though, you know, it doesn't come naturally to you to lose weight or even naturally to build muscle. You kind of are in the mid-ground. So when you've got a t-shirt on, or let's say if it's a woman and they got a dress on, you can kind of tell they're in the mid-range. And then the endomorph. Now, the endomorph is normally looked at from afar as a little bit overweight, okay? A little bit wide on the shoulders as well and on the back, easily storing weight around the mid area. So the visceral fat would be a little bit higher than usual. And that would be normally the three different body types. Now, when I look at those three, and for me, when you're younger, you're like, okay, you know what? I'm a mesomorph, let's say. But then when you get older, you think, nah, I'm more of an endomorph because I'm carrying a bit more weight than I should do. Now, here's the thing. I can only speak on what I do. I can't really speak on everyone else, because everyone else is different. The activity is different. The recovery is different. The training volume is different. The nutrition is different. Also genetically as well. You've got to also consider that a lot of people inherit genes from, you know, their ancestors, et cetera, which put you in that bracket. But here's the thing. When you come to train the different body types, you're looking at body composition. Now, research continues to prove that physical training and consistency is obviously the key to sustaining one of the three body types. But sometimes you transition between one and the other. Now, it's all about habits and habitual change, which kind of then causes it to be normal rather than a chore, which a lot of the times we affiliate with health and fitness and nutrition as more of a chore, more of something that you've kind of you kind of have to do because it's not fun or et cetera, et cetera. But the human body is highly adaptable and always seeks homeostasis, which again, in the environment that you're in, will help that. So if you've got vitamin D in terms of the sun, or if you have your own, your own routine. So if you train a certain amount of times a week, if you recover a certain times a week, if you even focus on just having a cheat meal once a week or twice a week, however you do it, it kind of puts you in that category where, depending on what body type you are, that kind of helps you, you know, either put on muscle earlier in terms of the protein intake, even if you're vegan or if you're vegetarian, or even if you're not, if you'd like to eat meat. All these different factors requires you, and they normally have calculators online, macro calculators, which helps you kind of see where you're at in terms of how many carbohydrates you need, how many fats you need, how many protein you need for your body type once you've entered that in. So it's very, very interesting in the sense that every single person has their own, you know, calculator, whilst normally we look at someone or look at, let's say, an ideal situation, an ideal figure, and say, that's the type of body I would like to have. And it would be very, very different, because depending on the height, depending on the weight, depending on the activity of that person you're looking at, you can't really measure up with yourself, because it's probably different in this respect. So we're looking at these things today in terms of body type. I mentioned them earlier, I'll mention them again. They're three different body types: ectomorph, mesomorph, and endomorph. Which one are you? And even more, what I would say is, are you between two? And that's something that, again, this is according to Sheldon's definitions of the three body types. Sometimes you might think, you know what, I'm not really, you know, that type. I'm more in between the second. So for example, endomorph is, you know, it's different because they're quite slim, so it's hard for them to pack on muscles. While mesomorph, they've got a bit of muscle, but it might be more challenging to kind of sustain the mid-ground where you reduce body fat and increase muscle mass. But endomorph are generally quite big boned. So in that sense, when they carry that muscle, they might still have that muscle, but not necessarily find it easy to drop body fat percentage. And that's kind of where I thought about this, and obviously had it in my book Reset. With the three different body types, it's quite generic in that sense, the three different body types. What I do believe is, it's not a life sentence. You're not fixed to one. You don't have to stay under just one, you know, one body type. Everyone has their own thing. But what I do believe is, trying to find your own, the level of activity, the level of mental fitness as well, which is another thing, because obviously if you get yourself in the right frame of mind, you're able to execute the physical part even better. But then again, do you spend enough time on the mental fitness part? Do you spend enough time reading? We heard Jim Quick say, reading for the mind is what exercises for the body. So there are factors. Do you meditate? You know, do you stretch? Do you do yoga? Do you do ice baths? Do you do sauna? Do you go for just walks, just regular walks? Do you end up clearing your mind through that? So I think what I would ask you today is, which body type are you, and are you giving it the right attention it requires in order to execute the goal at the end of the day, which is endomorph, ectomorph, mesomorph? Let me know, 4215, Ittasalat Urdu, or slide into my DMs at Omar Alduri, and I'll be right back after this. Enjoy, folks.
This is the Halftime Show with Omar Alduri on Pulse 95.
Sure is that time. It's the Halftime Show with Omar Alduri. Thank you very much for tuning in today. Love the fact that I see faces from all around the world, and I got to give some shout outs here from people who are tuned in. Shout out to Masoud in India. Shout out to Mira. You've got Amun. You've got Nuri in Greece. You've got Shema in Morocco. Who else have we got here? We've got obviously Shakib. We've got as well Arta as well in the UAE. Lina's in the UAE representing as always. And thank you very much for everyone else also on TikTok who is tuned in. Right, okay. So one of the topics, actually it got brought to my attention the other day, is something I've read a lot about it. I'm not an expert at it, but I've read a lot about it, and I thought it was very important to bring to the surface today, is body dysmorphia. Now, if you're wondering what body dysmorphia is, BDD is body dysmorphic disorder, which is a mental health condition where a person spends a lot of time worrying about their flaws and their appearance. Now, these flaws are often unnoticeable to others, but not to that person who's looking at themselves in a certain way. And people of any age can have BDD, but it's the most common in teenagers and young adults. But the thing is a lot of things start from quite a young age, which is through our roots, through experiences mentally, which then we end up believing through habit physically. So the way that our eyes see certain things is very different to how, you know, how the reality of it is. And that's kind of where we kind of build up our own perception of BDD, body dysmorphia. And that's where, like, I'm thinking, you know, I know a few people who look fantastic, men, women, they're in great shape, but they would see certain flaws in the way they look, which then it almost comes up obsessive with that person. And it's not even the fact that they look bad or anything, but maybe something has happened which has triggered that from a young age and come into our adulthood, because, you know, the inner child in us is always there. So when you look at it, like when I was looking online, I was thinking, are there any cures from it? And some people saying more cognitive things, some people saying more brain things, there's a lot of therapy involved in it. But it said that there wasn't necessarily a specific type of cure about it, but it can be something that you work on to adjust, to adapt. And then I looked at, like, the things that trigger it as well. And certain factors, you know, that seem to increase the risk of developing or triggering body dysmorphia. Sometimes it can come from genetics, come from relatives. Sometimes it could be, you know, negative life experiences, you know, being bullied or teased at school, abuse, you know, all these certain things, because we often build up our own perception of perfectionism and what we should look like and how we should perform and how, like, if you're playing a sport, you should be a certain way. But the truth of the matter is we've kind of all built that up, and we've kind of watched things on social media. We've seen people, you know, in their finest hour or in their best moment and thought, right, that's how I want to be. But the reality of it is they're not actually always there. They build up to that. There's a lot of things we don't see, a lot of things that we don't end up coming across. And that's kind of where I think it's really important to be able to speak about this. And we've spoken about mental health a lot on the show. We've brought experts on here to speak about it. We even discussed it with athletes and coaches all around the world regarding it. And that's the kind of thing where it makes us think that even those athletes and even those superstars larger than life that we watch probably do have body dysmorphia, probably do have an element of not being comfortable in their own skin or not reaching the goals that they want. And that's okay as well. You know, it's not a bad thing. But one thing that's really important is to be able to manage that, to be able to strike the right balance. And the key word there is balance, because a lot of the times when people are talking, there's always this thing that we kind of have as a habit to say, yeah, me too. When in truth, you just kind of have to listen to what the person's saying and almost let them finish what they're saying and how they're saying it before being able to kind of step on board with advice, or even if you just want to encourage. But I think the key thing is not to isolate the person, not to be able to let that person feel alone. And that's where listening plays such a huge role in being able to help that person vent and create, you know, maybe a modified version of how they look, how they feel, how they recover, how they train. What is, you know, being comfortable in your own skin? You know, it's sometimes you see South Americans, when you go over, let's say, to the other side of the world, and you see Brazilians, for example. I'll give it Brazil because there was a time where I had some friends living in Brazil, and their body language is phenomenal, even if they are an endomorph, an ectomorph, a mesomorph. As we mentioned earlier in the show, if you just tuned in now, you're wondering, what is he talking about? We were talking about body types. Now, it doesn't really matter the body type as such. It matters the body language. And that language is what gets projected to those people around you, which then makes it a much better place to be around, a better environment, a better way to socialize, a better way to, you know, have good energy around. And that all comes down to how we self-love, self-care. And I think nowadays we're so busy giving love that we don't actually give that love to ourselves. And I know it sounds a bit, you know, like I'm running into deep, but the truth of it is even as a coach, us coaches require self-love, because we give so much that sometimes we have nothing left. And that's where it's really important, regardless of what industry you're in or what profession you're in, to be able to self-care, be able to be mindful, to be grateful. These things all play a big part in sports, but also in life. So let me know, 4215. Do you know anyone that suffers from body dysmorphia? Are you one of those people? If so, what are the signs that cause you to believe that? 4215, it's a salat or do, or slide into my DMs at Omar Alduri, and I'll be right back after this. Some Masego, the music is on point today. Enjoy it, folks.
This is the Halftime Show with Omar Alduri on Pulse 95.
Yes, we are back. Welcome back to the Halftime Show. Thank you very much for tuning in with me today. Love the energy in the room today, man. That's what makes me come in on a Saturday. Ain't that right, Sama? Yeah, we in here on a Saturday from Pulse 95 Radio, the heart of Sharjah on the Halftime Show, spending it with my favorite people online. And listen, you know what? One of my favorite people online happens to be, you know, this little gentleman right here. His name is Levi. He's 7. He loves green. He loves dodgeball and parkour as well. And he's always at a boxing gym as well representing. So shout out to Levi, who is tuned in to the Halftime Show, the only place to be at 3, with me. So yeah, so there you go, Levi. You got your little shout out there. Thanks, Mom. Okay, so now, if you're just tuning in, we were talking today about quite a few important things, actually. The first thing we were talking about is the different types of body type, and that was endomorph, ectomorph, and mesomorph, and which one are you, and is it possible to transition between the two? And the second segment, we spoke about body dysmorphia. Now, it was really, really important to bring this to the surface because, you know, I know friends who have it, and I know friends who, you know, who look fantastic and they're incredible in the way they look, they train, they everything, but they don't, there's no self-love, there's no self-care, and there's probably things that root from a long time which have been brought to the surface. And so I thought it was very important to kind of bring it to the attention, raise awareness on it, and kind of discuss it today. And now we're talking about sports. Now, a couple of things. Thank you for the compliment on the hoodie. It's from Rock Your Ugly. A shout out to Real SQ, Mira, Shaymat, Omnia, Louise, Levi, of course, Sati as well, and Masoud, and Dr. Dre, who's not that Dr. Dre, our Dr. Dre, and Farha as well. One of the things that Anita actually said on the Instagram live, which was very, very interesting, is she said, it's a very interesting and important topic. Everyone has their flaws that they may only notice. I believe it comes down to our mental state. We must know we're all unique and made exactly how we are, and we can never compare ourselves to others. Everyone is developed differently and experiences different experience. I love this topic. Self-love is very important. Thank you very much, Anita, and everyone else who is tuned in. Right, some sports happening this weekend. I can't begin to tell you how nervous I am, because Arsenal are playing Tottenham in the North London Derby this weekend. You will see me all over the place in the next couple of days, because there's either going to be, you know, this really big happy presenter that you have, or there's going to be someone that's really gutted because Tottenham are doing very well at the moment and Arsenal aren't, and they meet each other for bragging rights tomorrow at 8:30 UAE time, which is... can't begin to tell you. You know, actually, I'll tell you a little funny story. When Arsenal played Tottenham in 2000, this rung a bell. Arsenal played Tottenham in 2000. I was watching this with my mom in London, and we were in her room, and we're watching on the TV and everything, and Tottenham were winning 1-0, and I was just thinking, oh my God, I have to go face all these Tottenham fans who come out of, you know, their holes and tell me, you know, how amazing they are and everything. And Arsenal equalised in the last minute. It was 1-1, and it was a Patrick Vieira header. Okay, now here's the problem: when you love a team so much, and I've just seen Patrick Vieira head the ball in to equalize in the last minute. Okay, so as I was celebrating, I went, and I swear to God, I headbutted my mum's cupboard and broke her cupboard. Now I don't go around headbutting, and I don't promote it, and please don't do that. It's really not a smart thing. It's probably why I still got a couple of cells missing right now. But I've gone and broken my mom's cupboard with my head, celebrating euphoria that Patrick Vieira equalized against Tottenham. Now, the only reason why I remember this is because I was listening to a podcast yesterday, and they were talking about some of the moments that, you know, were long lasting in our memories, and I remembered that. And oh my God, I feel so bad for my mom's cupboard because it's still broken, I think, till now. So yeah, so that's how much it does mean to us Arsenal fans. What are you looking forward to this weekend? 4215, it's the Salat, or do any sports events that you are looking forward to? When we look around at the sports at the moment, you've got Muguruza, who sees off Mertens to set up the final with, oh God, these names, Krejcikova. I can't, honestly, I've left my tongue at home. In the tennis, you've got Murray to miss Dubai's tennis, which is going to happen. Messi to stay at Barcelona, people are talking about at the moment. In cricket, England thrash India in the T20 series opener. In football, the UAE to host the remaining World Cup qualifiers, and Milan grab a draw at Manchester United, despite there being some dodgy VAR decisions happening there. That's a quick roundup of the sports. There are a couple of things happening this week, and obviously a lot of things being discussed in the UFC as well, as Leon faces Bilal in the UFC matchup again, coming up very, very soon. But yeah, what are you looking forward to? Let me know. What up, Mustafa, man? We were talking about you earlier. I hope you guys are having a great day. We've got the music today is just fire. If you're behind the scenes, you know what I'm talking about. Coming up next, we are taking all your questions and comments from the day's episode. And if you did miss the show, don't worry, you can catch us on podcast, Apple, Spotify, SoundCloud. Or if you prefer a visual, head over to the YouTube channel and go to Pulse 95 Radio. And I am there with some fantastic guests covering some amazing topics. I'll see you after this Blessings remix. Enjoy.
This is the Halftime Show with Omar Adouri on Pulse 95.
It's that time. It's the Halftime Show with Omar Adouri. Thank you very much for tuning in with me today and keeping me company throughout the hour. The music has been fire, the show has been fire, and the content has been on point. So thank you again. What did we talk about today? We spoke about the different types of body types that we have, and also is it possible to be between two, as Sheldon has described it in research in recent years. Now, if you do have my book Reset, you know that I cover the three different body types in there, but sometimes it's possible to be able to fuel that by nutrition, by training, recovery, environment, and even the way your mindset is. So there's plenty of good stuff in there. And also we spoke about body dysmorphia, which is something that's very, very important out there for us to be able to address and raise awareness of, for those the people that are going through that, to be able to help by listening and also doing things like self-love and self-care. And we also spoke about some sports. Shakib is asking, what is your prediction for the Spurs-Arsenal derby? You see how I'm breathing? I'm breathing like this before we even started the match. We play Tottenham tomorrow at 8:30, and I saw some confident Tottenham fans speak to me, and especially one this morning who said to me, "You're going to lose quite badly." So I'm hoping that we don't lose quite badly and we turn it around. What do I think is going to happen? I probably will sit on the fence and say I'll take a draw, just because the form that Son, Bale, and Kane are at the moment now is kind of worrying. And also defensively, you know that Mourinho is always going to be very pragmatic in his approach, utilizing the fullbacks and keeping Højbjerg and the center of the midfield very, very tight. And that's going to be very hard to break down. Whilst with Arsenal, if you look at them at the moment now, we don't know who's going to start, because the focus and priorities in the Europa League due to the poor position that Arsenal are in the league. So players like Saka might be rested, which is normally the first person on the team sheet. Will Aubameyang play, seeing that he played the majority of the game the other night? And will there be space for someone like Lacazette? The centre-back pair, partnership at the moment now, will he go with Mari and Louise, or will he bring back, Gabriel, who played the other night, and pair them up? Tierney has to play for me at left back, a right back person. I think Cedric Suarez should start over Bellerin, but I have a feeling he might play Bellerin. And then Thomas Partey, who's had fitness issues all along, will be in the centre midfield. Does he partner Granit Xhaka, or does he rest Partey and not risk more injuries by playing Xhaka and Elneny, who scored a cracker the other night, or Xhaka and Ceballos for more creativity? So I'm telling you, it's going to be a very, very tough game. Shakib says, Arsenal to nick it for me and Odegaard to be the difference maker. Shakib, I hope you're right, man. And after your performance last Monday, you have every right to be right. Shout out to Florin, who's tuned in from New York as well. Don't worry, Florin, you get to see the YouTube once it comes out. Thanks to Super Mario and Gabby. Team news coming out from Chelsea versus Leeds. Chelsea are going to be with Mendy, Rudiger, Christensen, Azpilicueta, Zayac, Jorginho, Kante, Chilwell, Mount, Havertz, and Pulisic with a rest start, with Werner going to the bench and Callum Hudson-Odoi. As for Leeds, come on, Marco Bielsa, let's do this, man. Marcelo Bielsa is the man. He's got the usual lineup, actually. There's not many changes. Rafinha, good to see him in there. Phillips is back as well, and Bamford playing up front. Hey, guys, that is full time on the Halftime Show. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have, and thank you for everyone who has shown love today on the Instagram Live. It's that kind of day where we need a little bit of love, a little bit of self-care. So thank you very much, and I will see you same time, Same place every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday, 3 to 4, and the only place to be at 3, the Halftime Show on Pulse 95.